Hello. We are playing Berzerk for the Sega Mega Drive. Wow, copyright 1997, and the graphics look like Atari 2600. This has got to be public domain. Got to be Berzerk. That was a game for the Atari, wasn't it? Oh, it looks like it. All right, so this is something that someone's made after the Mega Drive. And it's found its way onto this site. I wonder if it ever got a cartridge. Something tells me it never got a cartridge. I might be wrong about that. Am I wrong? Answers on a postcard. That guy's a bit scary. Oh, I must not escape. Excellent. You know what, though? What? I just die. I was about to say I like it. But that was bobbins. And somehow, my controls have gone. I've lost control. Right, so you get one life and then you lose control and you've got to watch your character die over and over again. The level seems to be randomly jet. Oh yeah, I'm back now. Oh, really? Oh man, they shoot. Okay, no, see, I'm dead again. My controls have gone. You go back and your controls go. I'm not quite sure where the logic is there. You know what? I'd rather like this if it wasn't broken. I was about to say I'd rather like this just for it went all wrong. No! Oh, you can't. Oh! And if it was possible, there is that element too. Suddenly, the second screen onwards, it all goes wrong. I'm going to give this another go though because, I mean, I'm dead again. Look, frozen. Every other life seems to freeze you. I'm not quite sure. Or maybe this is a life loss sequence. And if so, it's really, really slow. Okay, let's start again. Now, I clearly lost lives then because it was broke. Something's broke about it. Okay. Oh, nice shot. I totally meant to do that, honest. So this first screen's dead easy because basically you've got a load of robots. None of them shoot at you. And I can totally handle it. There we go. Now, this time, I'm going that way. I like all that, that's cool. Okay, now, don't shoot at me. Let me just... Oh, they are going to shoot at me, though, I can tell. There we go. So you've got to keep your distance now, basically. We walked into each other. Oh, no, they're too close. Oh, oh, what? Oh, that's annoying. Why do the walls have to kill you? And now we've got to run through the sequence of watching the robots get close and then the little bouncy dude kill me. Basically, you're sitting waiting for a level to pass before you can control again. Oh, wait. Oh, I see. It's a two-player game, isn't it? Oh, right. It's automatically a two-player game. You don't get a choice about that. That's why it does that. Player 2 just lost life. Really? I was really looking forward to that go. And it generated right in my face. I've got to wait for player 2 to die now. Is there a controller? No. Shoot, no. Oh, paused. There will be a controller somewhere for player 2. Never mind. So I have to wait for him to die. So Berzerk, that was like a popular retro game, wasn't it? Like really retro. Well, not really retro, I guess. Well, yeah, really retro. Like the dawn of video games. And to be fair, it's great. This is actually, it's quite an exciting game. And it uses the environment well, and it proper puts you on the edge of your seat. This version is just it's not broke, it's just a whole two-player thing like this. You've got to play it two players, apparently. And it's a little bit too hardcore for my liking. But, other than that, pretty cool. I'd love to see a modern remake of that. I say modern, I mean 16-bit style, I think. Which is what this should have been, because let's face it, it's a Mega Drive. What were you thinking, Paul W. Lee? Not bringing it up to 16-bit standard. Your game is good, by the way. I like it. But I want to see it in, like, 16-bit. Anyway, that was Berzerk for the Sega Mega Drive. And not bad. Thanks for watching.